Giuliani's emergency bunker was there. Carolyn?
All the stuff from Enron was in there.
Yeah, I think Laurel mentioned it. But the Enron records that, and supposedly it was the only copies, how convenient.
A lot of other
right. Okay. Now, the way I'm coming at this, this is sort of like a personal approach here. I'm coming at this as a physics teacher. I see things happen and I say, how did that happen? And so this is a little, what I'm doing here is sort of illustrating a tool that I use in my teaching in a sort of a native context. Here I am at school standing on a ladder with a soccer ball and going, whomp, there's a physics experiment. That wasn't very smooth. Let's do it again. Boom. All right. Notice that this is a tool. What happens is you can go through it frame by frame and place little markers on something. And as you step through it frame by frame, like this, by the way, notice over here, if this jumps all over, okay. That thing right there is tracing where it is on the graph. And so by tracing, in other words, you have to manually put these, this, what I'm using as my mouse pad is causing this to jump. I don't know how I can fix that, but that's partly why this is so hard to control. Okay. So you get the general idea. This is a graph over here of position versus time, vertical position versus time. And notice that as I run it, if you watch this and watch the ball come down, it's like just watching a movie of the ball come down. But you can also do things like this. You can take, say, the vertical velocity. And notice this is a different kind of graph. And I want to explain this slightly because this is going to come into the picture in a few minutes. All right? As the velocity, if you look at the velocity as this thing comes down, it starts at rest, so it starts off at zero, like the zero there. And then as it comes down, it picks up speed. And it picks up uniform increments of speed in equal amounts of time. Okay? And that's the nature of what's called uniform acceleration. And that's characteristic of gravity. And so I wanted to let you see what that looks like. So we're graphing the velocity as a function of time. One of the things I can do is put this in an analyze mode. And it can start playing games with the graphs and the numbers. And so, for instance, I want to fit a graph to this. I'm going to select the range of data that I'm going to base it on. And I'm going to auto-fit this line. Let's make it a little bit more visible here. Hi.
Hi.
Aha. I just have a self-help enterprises mouse pad. Thank you. And it's working better. Great. All right. Self-help enterprises, by the way. Bard McAllister, for those of you who don't know it, was the founder of that in... Farm Labor Committee, under his leadership, founded the self-help enterprises there. Okay, a forerunner in a sense of habitat and that kind of a thing, right? Okay, notice that if I put a straight line through the data, and then you look at this little number down here, it says 9.70. If I try it again, if I take a few data points, notice the, it's trying to fit the line to the data, and data typically has a little bit of jitter to it, and so depending on how many data points I use and how accurately they were measured and all that, you're getting slightly different versions down here, and that's characteristic of any kind of data that you take in a measurement situation, okay? So, precise science is not necessarily one exact number, it's reasonably interpreting data, taking into account the kinds of errors that show up in measurement, okay? And notice this is 9.77 at this point right here. So this is very close to what would be considered the acceleration of gravity, 9.79 in this area, 9.8 a lot of places, all right? The reason I'm giving you that is that number is going to come back into the picture every once in a while. That's called G, or the acceleration of gravity, and it's also called free fall. And notice all we're talking about here is a soccer ball dropping under the influence of gravity, and this is how fast the speed builds up. So it's not correct to say, how fast do things fall? When I drop something, how fast does it fall? Well, how about in the first tenth of a second, how fast did it fall? It was hardly moving, was it? It picks up speed as it falls farther. And so what's characteristic of falling motion is not what is the speed, it's what is the acceleration. What's the rate of increase of the speed? Is that clear? You have to have a little bit of a physics lesson if you're going to listen to me talk about 9/11. Okay, there we go. Anyway, so this is the kind of a tool and the way I use it at school. Notice you can take lots of data and play all kinds of games with it much faster than when I was in school. We plotted each individual point with a pencil on a piece of graph paper. And I still have students do that somewhat. Okay, now, let's go back to 9/11. Let's play the same game with a building. When I saw, when I knew about Building 7, I had already heard that various people had measured the rate of acceleration of the corner of the building and had by various methods determined that it had come down either at or close to free fall. Now, what are the implications of a building collapsing straight down at free fall? Free fall is like a soccer ball with nothing under it. If you have vertical columns in a building, you have a lot of material in the building, then you have a lot of work to do crushing things as this thing is coming down. How is that going to happen at free fall? If you have energy due to the fact that all this stuff is stacked up high in the air, that energy gets transferred into motion. It's called kinetic energy once you get it moving. But if you have it doing things along the way, like breaking up concrete and steel and so forth, you're using some of the energy, and therefore it can't pick up as much speed as it would otherwise. And so the energy has to go somewhere, and it can't go everywhere. So if it starts off as what's called potential energy right now, as it if it is doing work along the way, it'll be coming down at less than free fall. What I did was I measured it. And so here I'm just playing it straight through. And this little corner right over here, okay, I didn't turn that on. I'll turn it on next time through. But notice the building coming down. Let's turn on the little dots now. And so I start taking the data just as it's about to fall. There we go. This little red dot's the one that I originally plotted. And all I'm doing is I'm putting a little marker on each frame to get a measurement. Now, to get this would measure it in pixels on the screen, but how do I know how actual far it is? What I had to do was get some sort of a known measurement. At first, I used the width of the building, but there's a problem. Look at this left edge. It's sort of foggy because of all that smoke, right? So I had to sort of estimate it. And I got sort of a number in the ballpark of free fall. But when in August of 2008, so just a little over a year ago, year and a half ago, NIST, which is the government agency that was put in charge of investigating these building collapses, they came out with their quote-unquote final report. It was called their final report for public comment. So it's sort of like the next to the most final report, okay? And in that report, it gave the height of the roof line and it gave the height of the 29th floor, the top of the windows of the 29th floor is what they said. And they gave those two heights down to the nearest inch. And I was able to use that data, convert it to meters, and put it in here. So now I had a good calibration. And what I came up with was that this corner came down essentially at G. My actual measurements, remember I said there's a little bit of round off and that kind of thing? My actual measurements are slightly faster than G. Now, I don't really believe there's some mechanism that's, you know, rockets pushing it down faster than gravity, but let me say it is not almost at G. It's not sort of 90% of G. It's at least G, and there could be some, who knows? Just because it's tilting and things like that, there could be reasons this point is coming down a little faster. When NIST came out with this report, all right, you see how fast it's coming down, and here's the actual data. Let me just go ahead and